Highway Patrol because there's an investigation underway right now into the tragic killing of a 23-month-old boy this weekend. Now, that toddler was in the back seat of his family's car asleep when he was struck by a stray bullet. And KTV's Ali Rasmus joins us now live with the very latest on that investigation. Very tragic.
Just horrific and disturbing to think about, Claudine. But the CHP investigators continue to ask for the public's help. They want more witnesses to come forward to help them find the people responsible for the killing of an innocent child. Jasper Wu was just weeks away from turning 2 years old. His mother was driving southbound on 880 near Filbert Street, 2 in the afternoon on Saturday, when seemingly out of nowhere, a bullet struck the windshield of the car, hitting the 23-month-old as he slept in his car seat in the back. The CHP says they do not believe the car that little boy was riding in was targeted. Instead, they say they have evidence that shows that that car may have been caught in the crossfire of other gunfire, possibly on the other side of the freeway. Investigators do not have a description of any vehicle that those shots may have been fired from. In the meantime, the young child's mother is in an unimaginable state of grief.
She's very strong. And she's staying strong because, you know, she is determined to get things done now. But I know she's holding up pretty well, but inside, I know she's crying like crazy. We're asking to ask the CHP to set up a patrol on the freeway and reviewing what they can see throughout the freeway. And I'm sure that, you know, their information they can gather, helping us to solve this crime.
Carl Chan is the president of the Oakland Chinatown Chamber of Commerce. He's been in direct contact and helping the little boy's mother and family with this situation. Jasper's father, who he never had a chance to meet in person, is arriving in the Bay Area today from China to help bury his son. Chan says the family is getting help from Oakland Police Victim Services. The Oakland Chinatown Chamber of Commerce is working to set up a GoFundMe account for the young victim's family. But in the meantime, Chan says he and other members of the Oakland community say they would like to have a greater police presence on the freeways from the CHP because, as he said, this could have happened to anyone driving on 880 in the middle of a Saturday afternoon. Live in the newsroom, Ali Rasmus, KTVU, Fox 2 News.